Network Lessons, Part 2. Broadcast Messaging. When hosts are connected using either a hub or a switch, a single local network is created. Within the local network, it is often necessary for one host to be able to send messages to all the other hosts at the same time. This can be done using a message known as a broadcast. Broadcasts are useful when a host needs to find information without knowing exactly what other host can supply it, or when a host wants to provide information to all other hosts in the same network in a timely manner. A message can only contain one destination MAC address. So, how is it possible for a host to contact every other host on the local network without sending out a separate message to each individual MAC? To solve this problem, broadcast messages are sent to a unique MAC address that is recognized by all hosts. The broadcast MAC address is actually a 48-bit address made up of all ones. Because of their length, MAC addresses are usually represented in hexadecimal notation. The broadcast MAC address in hexadecimal notation is FFFF, FFFF, FFFF. Each F in the hexadecimal notation represents four ones in the binary address. When a host receives a message addressed to the broadcast address, it accepts and processes the message as though the message was addressed directly to it. When a host sends a broadcast message, hubs and switches forward the message to every connected host within the same local network. For this reason, a local network is also referred to as a broadcast domain. If too many hosts are connected to the same broadcast domain, broadcast traffic can become excessive. The number of hosts and the amount of network traffic that can be supported on the local network is limited by the capabilities of the hubs and switches used to connect them. As the network grows and more hosts are added, network traffic, including broadcast traffic, increases. It is often necessary to divide one local network, or broadcast domain, into multiple networks to improve performance. MAC and IP. On a local Ethernet network, a NIC only accepts a frame if the destination address is either the broadcast MAC address, or else corresponds to the MAC address of the NIC. Most network applications, however, rely on the logical destination IP address to identify the location of the servers and clients. What if a sending host only has the logical IP address of the destination host? How does the sending host determine what destination MAC address to place within the frame? The sending host can use an IP protocol called Address Resolution Protocol, ARP, to discover the MAC address of any host on the same local network. Address Resolution Protocol, ARP. ARP uses a three-step process to discover and store the MAC address of a host on the local network when only the IP address of the host is known. 1. The sending host creates and sends a frame addressed to a broadcast MAC address. Contained in the frame is a message with the IP address of the intended destination host. 2. Each host on the network receives the broadcast frame and compares the IP address inside the message with its configured IP address. The host with the matching IP address sends its MAC address back to the original sending host. 3. The sending host receives the message and stores the MAC address and IP address information in a table called an ARP table. Once the sending host has the MAC address of the destination host in its ARP table, it can send frames directly to the destination without doing an ARP request. Distribution layer. As networks grow, it is often necessary to divide one local network into multiple access layer networks. There are many ways to divide networks based on different criteria, including physical location, logical function, security requirements, application requirements, The distribution layer connects these independent local networks and controls the traffic flowing between them. It is responsible for ensuring that traffic between hosts on the local network stays local. Only traffic that is destined for other networks is passed on. The distribution layer can also filter incoming and outgoing traffic for security and traffic management. Networking devices that make up the distribution layer are designed to interconnect networks, not individual hosts. Individual hosts are connected to the network via access layer devices, such as hubs and switches. The access layer devices are connected to each other via the distribution layer device, such as routers. Function of routers. A router is a networking device that connects a local network to other local networks. At the distribution layer of the network, routers direct traffic and perform other functions critical to efficient network operation. Routers, like switches, are able to decode and read the messages that are sent to them. Unlike switches, which only decode, unencapsulate, the frame containing the MAC address information, routers decode the packet that is encapsulated within the frame. The packet format contains the IP addresses of the destination and source hosts, as well as the message data being sent between them. The router reads the network portion of the destination IP address and uses it to find which one of the attached networks is the best way to forward the message to the destination. Anytime the network portion of the IP addresses of the source and destination hosts do not match, a router must be used to forward the message. If a host located on network 1.1.1.0 needs to send a message to a host on network 5.5.5.0, the host will forward the message to the router. The router receives the message and unencapsulates it to read the destination IP address. It then determines where to forward the message. It re-encapsulates the packet back into a frame, and forwards the frame onto its destination. How does the router determine what path to send the message to get to the destination network? Each port, or interface, on a router connects to a different local network. Every router contains a table of all locally connected networks and the interfaces that connect to them. These routing tables can also contain information about the routes, or paths, that the router uses to reach other remote networks that are not locally attached. When a router receives a frame, it decodes the frame to get to the packet containing the destination IP address. It matches the address of the destination to all of the networks that are contained in the routing table. If the destination network address is in the table, the router encapsulates the packet in a new frame in order to send it out. It forwards the new frame out of the interface associated with the path to the destination network. The process of forwarding the packets toward their destination network is called routing. Router interfaces do not forward messages that are addressed to the broadcast MAC address. As a result, local network broadcasts are not sent across routers to other local networks. Default gateway. The method that a host uses to send messages to a destination on a remote network differs from the way a host sends messages on the same local network. When a host needs to send a message to another host located on the same network, it will forward the message directly. A host will use ARP to discover the MAC address of the destination host. It includes the destination IP address within the packet and encapsulates the packet into a frame containing the MAC address of the destination and forwards it out. On the other hand, when a host needs to send a message to a remote network, it must use the router. The host includes the IP address of the destination host within the packet just like before. However, when it encapsulates the packet into a frame, it uses the MAC address of the router as the destination for the frame. In this way, the router will receive and accept the frame based on the MAC address. How does the source host determine the MAC address of the router? A host is given the IP address of the router through the default gateway address configured in its TCP/IP settings. The default gateway address is the address of the router interface connected to the same local network as the source host. All hosts on the local network use the default gateway address to send messages to the router. Once the host knows the default gateway IP address, it can use ARP to determine the MAC address. The MAC address of the router is then placed in the frame, destined for another network. It is important that the correct default gateway be configured on each host on the local network. If no default gateway is configured in the host TCP/IP settings, or if the wrong default gateway is specified, messages addressed to hosts on remote networks cannot be delivered. Tables maintained by routers. Routers move information between local and remote networks. To do this, routers must use both ARP and routing tables to store information. Routing tables are not concerned with the addresses of individual hosts. Routing tables contain the addresses of networks and the best path to reach those networks. Entries can be made to the routing table in two ways. Dynamically updated by information received from other routers in the network, or manually entered by a network administrator. Routers use the routing tables to determine which interface to use to forward a message to its intended destination. If the router cannot determine where to forward a message, it will drop it. Network administrators configure a routing table with a default route to keep a packet from being dropped because the path to the destination network is not in the routing table. A default route is the interface through which the router forwards a packet containing an unknown destination IP network address. This default route usually connects to another router that can forward the packet towards its final destination network. A router forwards a frame to one of two places. A directly connected network containing the actual destination host, or to another router on the path to reach the destination host. When a router encapsulates the frame to forward it out of an Ethernet interface, it must include a destination MAC address. This is the MAC address of the actual destination host. If the destination host is part of a network locally connected to the router. If the router must forward the packet to another router, it will use the MAC address of the connected router. Routers obtain these MAC addresses from ARP tables. Each router interface is part of the local network to which it is attached and maintains its own ARP table for that network. The ARP tables contain the MAC addresses and IP addresses of all of the individual hosts on that network. Local Area Network, LAN. The term Local Area Network, LAN, refers to a local network, or a group of interconnected local networks that are under the same administrative control. In the early days of networking, LANs were defined as small networks that existed in a single physical location. While LANs can be a single local network installed in a home or small office, the definition of LAN has evolved to include interconnected local networks consisting of many hundreds of hosts, installed in multiple buildings and locations. The important thing to remember is that all of the local networks within a LAN are under one administrative control. Other common characteristics of LANs are that they typically use Ethernet or wireless protocols, and they support high data rates. The term intranet is often used to refer to a private LAN that belongs to an organization, and is designed to be accessible only by the organization's members, employees, or others with authorization. Adding hosts local and remote networks. Within a LAN, it is possible to place all hosts on a single local network or divide them up between multiple networks connected by a distribution layer. The answer depends on desired results. Placing all hosts on a single local network allows them to be seen by all other hosts. This is because there is one broadcast domain and hosts use ARP to find each other. In a simple network design, it may be beneficial to keep all hosts within a single local network. However, as networks grow in size, increased traffic will decrease network performance and speed. In this case, it may be beneficial to move some hosts onto a remote network. Placing additional hosts on a remote network will decrease the impact of traffic demands. However, hosts on one network will not be able to communicate with hosts on the other without the use of routing. Routers increase the complexity of the network configuration and can introduce latency, or time delay, on packets sent from one local network to the other. Plan and document an Ethernet network. Most local networks are based on Ethernet technology. This technology is both fast and efficient when used in a properly designed and constructed network. The key to installing a good network is planning before the network is actually built. A network plan starts with the gathering of information about how the network will be used. This information includes the number and type of hosts to be connected to network, the applications to be used, sharing and internet connectivity requirements, security and privacy considerations, reliability and uptime expectations, connectivity requirements including wired and wireless. There are many considerations that must be taken into account when planning for a network installation. The logical and physical topology maps of the network need to be designed and documented before the networking equipment is purchased and the hosts are connected. Some things to consider include physical environment where the network will be installed, temperature control. All devices have specific ranges of temperature and humidity requirements for proper operation. Availability and placement of power outlets. Physical configuration of the network. Physical location of devices such as routers, switches, and hosts. How all devices are interconnected. Location and length of all cable runs. Hardware configuration of end devices such as hosts and servers. Logical configuration of the network. Location and size of broadcast and collision domains. IP addressing scheme. Naming scheme, sharing configuration, permissions, multi-function device. Most home and small business networks do not require high-volume devices used in large business environments. Smaller-scale devices may well be suitable. However, the same functionality of routing and switching is required. This need has led to the development of products that have the functionality of multiple network devices, such as a router with switching functionality and a wireless access point. For the purpose of this course, multi-function devices will be referred to as integrated routers. Integrated routers can range from small devices designed for home office and small business applications to more powerful devices that can support enterprise branch offices. An integrated router is like having several different devices connected together. For example, the connection between the switch and the router still occurs, but it occurs internally. When a broadcast is received on a switch port, the integrated router forwards the broadcast to all ports including the internal router connection. The router portion of the integrated router stops the broadcasts from going any further. There are low-cost multi-function devices available for home and small business networks that offer integrated routing, switching, wireless and security capabilities. An example of this type of integrated router is a Linksys wireless router. They are simple in design and do not typically have separate components. In the event of a failure, it is not possible to replace any single failed component. As such, they create a single point of failure, and are not optimized for any one function. Another example of an integrated router is the Cisco Integrated Services Router, or ISR. The Cisco ISR product family offers a wide range of products, including those designed for small office and home office environments as well as those designed for larger networks. Many of the ISRs offer modularity and have separate components for each function, such as a switch component and a router component. This enables individual components to be added, replaced, and upgraded as necessary. Connecting the Linksys router. All devices connected to the switch ports should be in the same broadcast domain. This means that all devices must have an IP address from the same network. Any device that has a different network portion within the IP address will not be able to communicate. Additionally, Microsoft Windows makes use of computer names to identify other devices on the network. It is important to use these names as well as all IP address information in the planning and documentation to assist in future troubleshooting. To display the current IP configuration in Microsoft Windows, use the command ipconfig. More detailed information, including host name, is available with the ipconfig, all. Document all information from the connection and configuration process. Once hosts are communicating across the network, it is important to document network performance. This is known as determining the baseline for the network, and is used as an indication of normal operations. When comparing future network performance with the baseline, it can indicate if possible issues exist. Sharing resources. One of the most common purposes of networking is to share resources such as files and printers. Windows XP enables remote users to access a local machine and its resources through sharing. It is important to consider security issues, and to assign specific permissions to shared resources. By default, Windows XP uses a process known as simple file sharing. With simple file sharing, specific users and groups cannot be prevented from accessing shared files. Simple file sharing can be disabled so that more specific security access levels can be assigned. When this is done, the following permissions are available to assign to resources. Full control. Modify. Read and execute. List folder contents. Read. Write. When a user accesses a file on a remote device, Windows Explorer allows the user to map a drive to a remote folder or resource. This maps a specific drive letter, for example M, to the remote resource. This enables the user to treat the resource as though it was locally connected.